First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way. Hi dear students, I am teacher Elisa and I'm so excited to welcome you today to this online class where we will be learning all about lesson 2. Now, we will start this class with the vocabulary on page number 19. Okay guys, let's start. Now please open your book at page number 19. As you know, in this page we have to do two activities. In the first step, we have to listen and point to the word in your book. Then you have to listen a number. And of course, at the end, you have to say which one is the missing word. In the step number 2, you have to listen and identify the word in the sentence. You have to underline with colors or you can use your highlighter. Are you ready? Let's start.
Lesson 2. The words you will hear are not necessarily in the same order as the ones in the book. Watch out for the missing word. Thorns. Thorns.
Thorns.
Rattlesnake.
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 Remember, you are in number 2.
Rough. Rough.
Rough.
Lasso.
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 Bark.
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 Remember, this is number 5.
Scooped.
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 Scooped. Listen and repeat, please.
Hedgehog. Hedgehog.
Hedgehog.
Buckle. Buckle.
Buckle.
Gooseberry.
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 Tumbleweed.
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 Stallion.
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 Please repeat. Stallion.
Prairie.
Prairie.
Prairie. Ripping.
Ripping.
Ripping. Noggin.
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 Pounding.
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 Pounding. And of course, did you guess which one is the missing word? Yes, you are right. The missing word is twister. Now let's check your answer. Number 1 is thorns. Number 2 is rattlesnake. Number 3, roof. Number 4, lasso. Number 5, bark. Number 6, scooped. Number 7, hedgehog. Number 8, buckle. Number 9, gooseberry. Number 10, tumbleweed. Number 11, stallion. Number 12, prairie. Number 13, ripping. Number 14, nugging. Number 15, pounding. And the last one is the word twister. If you did, you did a good job. Now, okay guys, in these pictures, here we have the words from the vocabulary. So you can have clear the meaning of this word. In number 1, look at this picture, is thorn. Look at this one, we can have an example, and we can say that flowers have thorns. Look at this one, all of them are thorns. In the next picture we have, look at this one, it is a rattlesnake. This is the name of this dangerous snake. In number 3 we have the word roof. In this one, we can say an example, the wall is roof. So, because roof is the material, it is not delicate, it is roof. Look at in the next picture, we have a lasso. The action, the man is trying to catch the ball with the rope. This action is called lasso. In number four, in number five, we have the word bark. Bark. Here, as you can see in the picture, here we have something on the tree. If you take off this material, we call this one bark, and we can make paper with this material. In the next picture, we have this animal, this small animal with spikes. Its name is hedgehog. And this one, we have a good example of vocal. So, look at this. Usually, a man, but a woman as well, use this kind of vocal. And the next picture, we have the word gooseberry. In this case, we have some gooseberries. It is a sour fruit. In the next picture, we have this word that is tumbleweed. This is like a plant. Actually, it's not a plant, but it is something like a material that rolls, especially in dry places. Next word, we have psyllium. Here, look at this one. Here, we have an psyllium. Especially in this picture, we can say that this is an wild stallion. And look at the next picture we have. In this one, it's called prairie. This beautiful prairie where animals run around here could be. In the next picture, we have the word ripping. Look at this one. What is happening with the tree? It's ripping from the land in this one. In the next one, we have pounding. Look at the action here. This is pounding. Look at its heart, where it's happening. Pounding. And the last word, we have twister. Twister is the action, like a move. So for example, we can say that a tornado looks like a twister because it moves like this one. It is a twister. Okay? So I hope that you have better idea about the meaning of this word. Now we are going to check on page 19 the sentences. First, you are going to listen the sentences and then you are going to underline the words. Please take your highlighter or you can use your color. Ready? Let's start.
Lesson 2. The words you will hear are not necessarily in the same order as the ones in the book. Scooped.
Scooped.
There were so many fish that we just scooped one up.
Scooped one up. Underline the word scoop.
Rattlesnake. Be careful not to run into a rattlesnake.
Be careful. Can you underline
rattlesnake? Prairie. Buffalo ate the grass that covered the vast, flat prairie. Pounding.
Pounding.
Loud pounding sounds come from the construction site.
Pounding.
Stallion. We had stallion. To catch the wild stallion before taming and riding it.
As I told you here, we have like a horse, a wild horse.
Hedgehog.
Do you remember?
A hedgehog.
Do you remember the spiky animal in this one? That is a hedgehog.
Loud pounding sounds come from the construction site. Stallion. We had to catch the wild stallion before taming and riding it.
I repeat the sentence.
Hedgehog. A hedgehog is a spiky animal that likes to live in bushes.
Do you remember the animal that I show you in the picture?
Gooseberry. At the gooseberry farm, We ate a lot of the sour green fruit.
Do you remember the green sour fruit? We usually eat that
noggin.
With salt.
Noggin is an informal word for a person's head.
Noggin. It could be instead of boss.
Ripping. The wind was ripping through the trees, knocking them over.
Do you remember the tree in the picture? That is the action that's ripping.
Bark. The bark of this tree can be taken off and made into paper.
Bark from the trees.
Rough. This wall is too rough, so we have to smooth it out.
We are taking the material in this one.
Buckle. The prize buckle for winning was a shiny buckle for a belt.
Buckle, do you remember? In the belt, usually men use that or wear that.
Tumbleweed.
Tumbleweed.
A tumbleweed rolled through the old town square.
Do you remember? It's like a small roll, small ball, like a bushes or something.
Twister.
Twister?
You can call a tornado a twister because of its twisty shape.
Twisted shape. Do you remember the tornado? I say twister.
Thorns.
Thorns.
You have to watch for thorns when you are picking roses.
Do you remember the roses, the picture? They have thorns, flowers, roses, especially.
Lasso.
Lasso? The action.
One of the events at the rodeo is to lasso a bull.
We have the sentence. Now, on page number 20, let's practice your pronunciation. Then you have to write the correct words in the blanks below. In number one, we have some words. Here in the number one is which words from the list start with the R sound. So please check again the vocabulary and try to find the words that start with R. For example, it could be the word ripping. In number two, we have which words from the list have a K sounds like cut. In this one, you have to find the word. It could be, for example, the word bark, bark. In number three, we have which words from the list have long U sound like chew. In this one could be gooseberry. In number four, we have which words from the list have the L sounds like a twirl. In this one could be the word lasso. Try to do the rest of them by yourself. When you finish this activity, please go to the next activity. In this activity, you have in the table here, classify the words from the list by number one syllable. So for example, in number one we have one syllable, two syllables, and three syllables. You have to look at the words and try to find them. Example, in number one with one syllable could be one syllable, bark. Do you remember with your hands? Bark. In number two, we have the word, in this one could be the word lasso, two syllables. In the next group, number three, we have three syllables. In this one, an example could be the word gooseberry, gooseberry. Okay, try to do this activity by your own. You will have 5 minutes to finish this activity. And then we will move on page number 21 in order to continue practicing the vocabulary. Now please go to page number 21. As you know, in this activity, in this kind of activity, we have two exercises. In the first exercise, you have to listen and pronounce, and then you have to write the words here. But now, what are you going to do is write all of the words twice in this space. Okay? In this space, you are going to write the word twice. So, try to do this activity. In this space, you are not going to write anything. Just in this space, you are going to write the words twice. So, for example, if you write in this one, lasso, you repeat two Time, two more times. Lasso, lasso, lasso. Try to complete this space. If you need more space, you can use this space. In order to make a dictation by your own, trying to practice the vocabulary, trying to practice the spelling. Okay? Now, move on to the next page, page number 22. In this one, we have another exercise that we can help you to reinforce the vocabulary. So, in this one, we have circle the words that it is spelled correctly. So, in this one, we have four options. You have to check if you want, check with the vocabulary, and try to choose which one is the correct one. So, for example, in this one, we have A, V, C, and D. And you have to choose which one is the correct one. So, if you say that it is letter B, underline, or it could be just color, try to do this one by your own. When you finish this activity, you are going to go to the next page, page number 23. Okay, guys, in this page, you have some sentences where you have to identify the wrong word. So, for example, you have to read the sentence and try to figure out which one is the wrong word. Of course, they are words from the vocabulary. So, for example, in number one, we have the only thing moving on the road was a bit of prairie. So, here we have the word prairie. Do you think that this word fits well in the sentence according to the context? Of course, no, because the prairie can move, right? So, in this one, you have to look at the words in the vocabulary and try to figure out which one is the word. For this activity, you are going to have 5 minutes. You have plenty of time. Don't worry in this one, you have plenty of time. At the end, we are going to check the answer of all of the exercise. Okay, guys, now let's check your answer. This one, in this page, we have the answers about the pronunciation. So you can check with your answer, and if you made mistakes, please correct them. Here we have the words, and the next activity we have the syllables. Please check the syllables. Remember, you can use your hands and clapping your hands in order to identify if it is one syllable, or it could be two syllables, or it could be the three syllables. So, for example, if we say gooseberry, in that way you can identify the number of syllables. Okay. Now let's check the answers of the other activity. Here we have this one. You can check the answer if you did a good job. In this activity, it is easy because you could check the vocabulary that you have, the words that you have in your vocabulary, just the spelling. And in the last activity about the sentences, remember that you have to cross out the word that was incorrect. So here we have, so for example, as I told you, here we have the word prairie. It is the wrong word. So according to the context, the correct word is tumbleweed in this one. You can check the picture. You can check the picture that I show you and identify which one is the word tumbleweed. And here we have the answer in all of the exercises. Okay? So guys, we have finished for today lesson 3 about vocabulary. I hope you have learned a lot about this lesson. So guys, we have finished, and please, in the next days, I'm going to set some homework in live worksheet about vocabulary. So keep practicing the pronunciation. If you don't know or you didn't understand the one word, please use your dictionary. Listen, and watch the video again and again. And see you soon, guys. Have a good day. Bye.